Hello,
Today
today I am going to discuss about second part of the rigid coupling or second type of rigid coupling, which is split Muff coupling or split slip coupling. Another name of this clamp coupling or compression coupling. This is the basic diagram of the slave or muff split muff coupling or clamp or compression coupling, in which it is a basic type of geometry. In between muff coupling and split muff coupling, basic difference is that we basically cut the sleeve or a muff into two separate parts, and to align input and output shaft in a same axis, we put this sleeve into two separate parts, and after the putting the input and output shaft in the around the half of the sleeve or muff, we clamp them with respect to bolt nut bolt arrangement and tighten. Here I am using capital D is the outer dia of the sleeve, L is the length of sleeve, small d is the diameter of the shaft. This is the length of sleeve, this is the diameter of the shaft. This is the side view of the split muff coupling. So basic design procedure to design a split or muff coupling, split muff coupling or split sleeve coupling or compression or clamp coupling. First step is same as a previous type muff coupling or sleeve coupling. First we need to calculate the diameter of the shaft. To calculate diameter of the shaft, in a problem we always know the power and speed of the motor or input shaft. With the help of that we can calculate torque. With the help of torque we can calculate, with the help of torsional equation, diameter of the shaft, which is 1060 mt by pi d q. As I have already discussed that the shaft and key are basically made up of plain carbon steel, but here one another element is come out as a clamping bolt, which is also made up of plain carbon steel. Second step, after calculating the diameter of the shaft, we can calculate the dimension of the sleeve, which is the diameter, outer diameter of the sleeve or muff, and the length of the sleeve or the muff. Capital D is equal to 2.5 times of diameter of the shaft, and L is equal to 3.5 times of diameter of the shaft. And sleeve, as I have already discussed, that made up of gray cast iron in previous topic, muff coupling or a sleeve coupling. The grade is, grading can be done in the basis of FG 200, where F is represent, F is representing iron, G represents gray cast iron, and 200 represents the value and the tensile strength of the material, gray cast iron material. Step number 3 or step number C, in that we basically calculating the, as similar as muff coupling, calculating the dimension of the key. Basically in the muff coupling or sleeve coupling, for design simplification we use flat key B to, when we use square key as a design element for key, B is equal to H, height and width is equal to same, 1/4 value of the diameter. When we use flat key as a design of key element, then the 1/4 value of diameter of the shaft is a width, and 1/6 value of the diameter of the is the height of the length of the key is depending on the length of the sleeve, half the length of sleeve. As I have already discussed that in a muff or sleeve coupling, length of key in each shaft is 1/2 of the length of the sleeve, because 1/2 of the shaft is connected in a half section of the sleeve, and remaining half shaft is connected by remaining half length of the sleeve. To connect both of the shaft, we need half length of the sleeve to each shaft. Next step is to check that whether this B and H value is safe enough to bear the torque value or power or speed. So we use basic shear stress and compressive stress equation, which I have already derived in previous lectures. if the tau and sigma c is induced value is lesser than the permissible value, then the material is safe to check, material is safe to bear the torque or power or speed. Next step is to calculate the diameter of the clampy bolt, which is the additional element in the sleeve and muff coupling. In the previous muff and sleeve coupling, we are using one section of the sleeve, not a separate sleeve, split sleeve. Here we use two parts of the sleeve which we need to connect with the help of bolts, clamping bolts. Here I am assuming that D1 is the diameter of the or minor diameter of the clamping bolt. So the bolt is have a circular section. So clamping bolt force on each bolt is P1 pi by 4. For circular section, area will be pi by 4 D1 square, because the diameter of the clamping bolt is D1. So area will be pi by 4 D1 square. Because here the component will have a tensile stress, so P1 will be the clamping force on each bolt is P1 is equal to pi by 4 D1 square into sigma t. This is the free body diagram of the shaft. Is this N force is the normal which is acting on the shaft due to couple, due to the sleeve or muff. When the shaft is rotating anti-clockwise, the friction force Fn will act in the normal opposite to the rotation of the shaft. Fn is the frictional force which is acting on the shaft opposite to the rotation of the shaft. Assume that the half number of the bolt given clamping pressure on input shaft and remaining half of the on the output shaft. You can see here in this figure, half of the number of bolts are considering for one half of the shaft, and remaining half will be considering for remaining half of the shaft. So clamping force, normal force, clamping force on each shaft can be considered as the N normal force, which is P1. P1 is the clamping force for each bolt into N. N is the number of bolt divided by 2 for one half. Frictional force can be considered as total. Mt is the anti-clockwise direction. So Mt is equal to, considering total effect, summation M is equal to 0. Mt is in a clockwise direction. Mt is in an anti-clockwise direction. Mt is equal to Fn is an opposite direction, which is the distance from center of the shaft. Fn into d by 2 plus Fn into d by 2. Both Fn has the same direction because it is the opposite and a frictional force which is opposite to the direction of motion of the shaft. So the frictional torque will be Mt is equal to Fn into d by 2 for this first part and remaining Fn into d by 2 for this one with respect to center of the shaft. So Mt can be written as Fn into d. D is the diameter of the shaft. To simplify this equation, we can put this N value from here to here to calculate the diameter of the bolt. We can achieve this equation number E1 and E2. From equation E1, we can calculate P1, or we can calculate diameter of the shaft. And with, or we can say that first we need to calculate torque with the help of, we can say that first we need to calculate P1 from this equation, because Mt we already we can calculate from initial condition, power and speed, and friction force will be given to us. D is the diameter shaft, we can calculate from initial condition. N is the number of bolt which we know, how much number of bolt we need to use to connect the muff. So here from this equation E2 we can calculate P1. We can put this P1 value to here. With the help of this equation E1 we can calculate diameter of the clamping bolt. So I hope you like this video and you have understand all the concept, basic concept of design procedure of the split muff coupling. If you have any doubt, then please comment below this video and please press the like button if you like this video, and please subscribe. Don't forget to subscribe my channel, and after subscription please press the bell icon to know further notification related to my channel videos uploading. Thank you.